Hey everybody, this is David from DwyerOmega. We get a lot of questions from customers about how to scale a DP41-S meter without a known load. So take a load off, don't strain your brain, we'll break it down for you right here. The Omega DP41-S offers exceptional stability and high performance in a strain gauge meter. For this setup, we'll be using an LC103B-1K high accuracy S-beam load cell, an AC power cord that I wired to the terminal block connector included with the DP41-S. And here's the star of this video, our DP41-S series digital strain meter. So since we're operating in unipolar mode to read 0 to 100 millivolt input, there's no need to change any of the jumpers on this meter, because when the meter ships out to you, it's set to accept 0 to 100 millivolt inputs. If you want to read in bipolar configuration, refer to page 6 of the quick start manual. The link to the quick start is down below in the description of this video. So to begin configuring this meter, make sure your load cell is connected to the meter. So if you look at the back of the meter, you'll see two gray connectors, P3 and P9. You'll also find this on section 2 of the quick start manual. And your positive excitation will be connected to the first hole on terminal block number P9. And your negative excitation will connect to the first hole on terminal block P3, which is the terminal block at the bottom. Your positive signal will connect to the second hole on terminal block P9. And your negative signal will connect to the third hole on terminal block P9. To figure out your color codes for your negative and positive excitation and signals, refer to your calibration certificate. So to scale the meter, we only need three parameters, namely RDGSC, which stands for reading scale, RDGOF, which stands for reading offset, and DECPT, which stands for decimal point. To calculate your RDGSC, we'll use the following formula. RDGSC equals the display span, in other words, that's the total range of your load cell, divided by the sensor's millivolt per volt times natural gain of the meter, which also happens to be 10,000. So for example, in this instance, we have a 1,000-pound load cell, and it has a 3 millivolt per volt sensitivity. The sensitivity can be found by referring to your calibration certificate that shipped with your load cell. So your RDGSC would be 1,000 divided by 3 times 10,000, which comes up to 0.03333. So we have wired the load cell to the meter, so let's dive in and start pushing some buttons. To begin with, press the menu button until you see input. And now press the min button once, you'll see bridge flashing. Press the menu button once to save it. Press the menu button again, you'll see RDG.cnf. You don't need to make any changes in RDG.cnf. Press the menu button again, you'll see RDG.sc, which stands for reading scale. To enter the RDG.sc, press the min button once, and you'll see whatever value was set by default when it shipped to you. So this value should be entered with the value that you calculated. In this instance, it's 0.03333. In order to change this value, you can use the min and the max key. The min key basically scrolls through the value of the digits, and the max button changes the value of the digits, as you can see. So I'm going to go ahead and set the value to 0.0333. Let's go over, change it to 3. Let's go over, change it to 3. So now, once you've set this value to whatever you calculated this value to be, press the menu button once. It'll flash stored, and it'll take you to the next menu item, which is RDGOF, which also stands for reading offset. Now, you don't need to do anything as of yet. So press the menu button again and again till you see DECPT, which is your decimal point. Now press the min key once to enter this menu, and you'll see a bunch of Fs and the decimal point flashing in between. You can adjust your decimal point to set it wherever you want. So in this instance, since we have a 1,000-pound load cell, I'm gonna set it to read FFFF.FF. So in order to do that, use the max key, and you can just scroll through the Fs, and I'm gonna set it to FFFF.FF. Press the menu button once, it'll flash stored, and then you'll go to the next item on the menu, which is count by. You don't need to do anything else. The meter is all set, it's programmed. Press the reset button twice. You'll go back to run mode. Now you'll notice that there is a small offset in the meter because most load cells have an inherent zero offset. To offset this value at no load, press the menu button continuously until you see RDGOF. RDGOF stands for reading offset. Press the min button to go into this menu, and it'll show you negative 0.00.00, Now put a value over here to offset the value that we saw initially. So at no load, we saw 3.8. So I'm going to put negative 3.8 over here in RDGOF. So go ahead and press the min button to scroll through the digits. Use the max button to change the value of the digit. So I'm gonna set it to minus 3.8. Press the menu button to store it. It'll flash stored. Press the reset button twice to go back to run mode. And there you have it. We programmed this meter and it reads in pounds force. So now if I manually apply a load on the load cell, you'll see the value of the load cell increasing in pounds force. So there you have it. We powered up the meter, connected the load cell to the meter, and configured it to read in pounds force. And as always, if you have any further questions, feel free to contact one of our application engineers at DwyerOmega.